ahead and think for a moment about your very favorite food. What is it? Pizza? Macaroni and cheese? Chicken salad? Sushi? Well, we all have different food preferences, but food is a source of large molecules that are needed for life called biomolecules. There are four major biomolecules that make up all of life, and this will be the focus of this video. Before we get into details about the four biomolecules, we need to talk about one very important vocabulary word, the word monomer. A monomer is a building block. If I had some large substance, the parts that make up the substance are called monomers, just like building blocks. We're going to talk a lot about monomers today because we need to understand what the biomolecules are made of. And we need to understand biomolecules because they're building components of life. So let's introduce the four biomolecules now and talk a little bit about their functions. We'll start with carbohydrates, carbs. Well, carbs are something that you've probably heard a lot about when people are talking about diets. You know, they try to go low carb, or maybe they want a lot of carbs. Diets always come and go. Pasta and breads are examples of foods heavy in carbohydrates. Carbs are actually a very important source of energy. In fact, that's one big function of carbs. They are a great fast source of energy. If you are a marathon runner, you might want to eat a lot of carbs the night before a race. Lots of marathon runners do this. It's called pasta loading. They eat a big pasta dinner the night before they go out on their marathon. Now, carbs have a monomer. Again, remember, monomers are building blocks. The monomer for a carb is a monosaccharide. I know that's a big mouthful, but monosaccharides make up carbohydrates. Next one up is a diverse group known as lipids. Lipids are better known as fats, and they have two different types of building blocks. One type of building block is called a fatty acid, and the other type is called a glycerol. Now, examples of lipids include butter, oil, and cholesterol. Lipids, though, they have a lot of great functions. You might think, well, that's fat. How good can fat be? Well, it just depends when you put it into context. For example, you know those really adorable seals that you see on calendars? They have this fluffy white hair. They're actually called a harp seal. Well, they only look like that when they're babies. When they get older, they're not quite as cute. In their little baby stage, they actually have a lot of this hair that they're born with that keeps them warm. But over time, they have to develop blubber. It's fat, and it helps keep them warm. Lipids are great for insulating. Also, you might not think about fats as being related to energy, but fats are a great source of long-term energy. They can store energy for a long, long time. Say, for example, you wanted to swim the English Channel. That's like 21 miles of swimming. And the fastest swimmers might be able to do that in 7 or 8 hours, but it might take a lot longer than that for the average swimmer. More like 25 hours, and that's a lot of swimming. Well, you would want to make sure that your body has enough lipids, enough stored fat that it can pull upon. Because after you burn off those carbohydrates, remember, carbs are the fast source of energy, well, you might not have enough energy storage unless you have some lipids on hand. Lipids also make up cell membranes, so they are very important for life because all living things are made of cells. Of course, an excessive amount of lipids could be a bad thing for your health. Remember, it's all about moderation. Okay, next, proteins. Now, when you hear about proteins, a lot of times you might think about power bars. They say they have a lot of protein in them and that they help with muscle building. Well, protein is great for muscle building. Examples of foods that are high in protein include meats and many types of beans. The monomers of protein are amino acids. So sometimes you see these labels that say, this has 20 amino acids in this food. And really, they're just trying to say that it has protein. Because proteins are made of amino acids, so that's just some fancy advertising for you. But in addition to being important for muscle development, protein is also very important for other functions, such as working in the immune system and acting as enzymes. Remember, enzymes are made of proteins, so proteins are important for the body. Now, when we start talking about genes, the DNA genes, not the genes you wear, The DNA codes for proteins that are very important for structure and function in the body. The last biomolecule is known as a nucleic acid. Nucleic acids include DNA and RNA, which we'll get to when we get to genetics. They have a monomer called a nucleotide. That's going to be an easy one for you to remember because nucleotide sounds a lot like nucleic acid. And if considering DNA and RNA, both of these are involved in genetic information for the coding of your traits. They are found in a lot of your food because whenever you eat something that came from something once living, it can still contain the DNA. For example, when you eat a strawberry, you're actually consuming all the cells that make up that strawberry. And in the nucleus of all those strawberry cells is DNA. Plants and animals both have DNA. In fact, any type of life must contain nucleic acids to direct the cell's activities. So we just powered through introducing the four biomolecules by providing examples, exploring their monomers, and giving some general functions. One last very important part to mention is the structure of these biomolecules. Understanding the structure can help with predicting their properties and easily being able to identify them. One thing I like to tell students to do is to write the four biomolecules in the same order that we went through: carbs, lipids, proteins, and nucleic acids. Then remember this mnemonic device that goes with these four biomolecules: Cho, Cho, Chon, Chomp. Instead of chomp at the end with an M, it's chomp at the end with an N. The C stands for carbon, the H stands for hydrogen, the O for oxygen. So carbs, lipids, proteins, and nucleic acids all have that CHO in there. It's just that proteins and nucleic acids also have an N, which is nitrogen. And nucleic acids additionally have a P, which is for phosphorus. So again, CHO, CHO, CHON, CHOMP. The major elements in the four biomolecules. Now, these elements are arranged differently in the four biomolecules. It's important to explore the arrangement of the elements in biomolecules because the structure of that arrangement greatly impacts the biomolecule function. So, to the Google to discover some biomolecule arrangement illustrations. Well, that's it for the Amoeba Sisters, and we remind you to stay curious.